Good morning and welcome to Thursday's edition of Channel Sport This Morning. I'm Tayo Salam.
Good morning and welcome. I'm Cecilia Omogbe.
Yes, right now we're ready to talk sports. I'm Austin Okonapan, and we will begin with what's going down at the MPFL Super 4 in Uyo, Akwa Ibom State. As it is, all teams are tied. We do not have a winner yet. So the teams will play one more game to determine who will be crowned champions of the MPFL Super 4.
Definitely, they will have to wait till Friday and see what's going to happen in that one. Okay, one we won't have to wait so long is for DR Congo. Remember, they won the tournament in 2009, but right now, everyone actually wants them to replicate that same form as they reach the final of the 2016 African Nations Championships.
Yes, good one for Congo. I remember I said yesterday that they will get to the final, but they had to do it the hard way. Mm-hmm. But they're in the final. That's what really matters. From Rwanda, we go to the USA, where Steph Curry caught fire in the nation's capital, scoring 51 points, including 11 three-pointers, to lead the Golden State Warriors past the Washington Wizards, 134-121.
Okay,
amazing performance. Austin Okonapan spoke too soon yesterday when he didn't want to talk about Golden State. But apparently, Steph Curry watches the show. Mm. Yeah.
Amazing, phenomenal, unbelievable performance by Steph Curry over my Son Young's team. Oh my goodness.
I can imagine what the discussion.
I can imagine what the discussion
will be like between you and Sonny tonight.
No, I'm sure Sonny will be ready. To talk tonight, but we keep saying it. This Golden State Warriors guys are amazing.
Amazing.
1 point.
I mean, in the first half, you had 25. Wow. Mm-hmm. And you were like, okay, what's going on here? This guy's on pace to actually score 100 points. You know, you slow down a bit, but then still finished with 36 points in the first half alone. Incredible performance by Steph Curry. He's arguably or unarguably and the greatest shooter in the NBA of all time.
This is all time.
Yes.
Okay. Absolutely. You can go to Washington.
Okay,
go
this is a show. Show
respect for the office of the president.
Yeah, we'll do a lot more NBA news later on in the show because there were other games that were played. But for obvious reasons, Steph Curry is hogging the limelight. So, yeah.
Definitely.
Okay. So when I say let's push for a proper test for the alien DNA, why are we though?
You're the one doing the pushing. So let you just update us on what is going on. That's all.
Player 51 points in the game. When we still talk about Kobe and what he did.
You know.
Kobe, come on, I'm still.
When
I am the MVP.
Exactly. That's exactly what happened. Take a bow, son.
Steph Curry on fire. Let's still stay with players are on fire. Aaron Okwadri and Abiodun Body, they did big things for themselves, you know, taking part in the Hungarian Open and the German Open. And we keep saying it here on this show that for you to get better, you must play competitions. Now the rankings are out and it looks good for the Nigerians.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, for Aaron Okwadri, I mean, moving, you know, from 48 places to like 37 position, right?
11 places up.
So that's really huge. He was at the Hungarian Open, he was at the German Open. Yeah. That's definitely made him to amass about 85 points.
Incredible.
So that definitely was huge for him.
Mm. And for, let's not forget Bode Abiodun as well, too. Like, we spoke about him as well, too. He's having a great time. He moved from 236 in the world to 213. Mm. And that's about 23 places up. And it all boils down to the fact that they were active, you know, during the month of January.
Right.
So now the February rankings are out. We've seen the effect, and that's what we want. That's what we want for all our sports and our sports stars. Yeah.
Mm. We can't stop talking about it. Aaron Okwadri now ranks 37th in the world. So let's hope he goes to the next ITF
tour. Yeah.
And then he does so well. He might just come back, get his number 30 position that is, you know, massive. Same thing with Omar Sarr. Is Omar Sarr doing well? We know that he plays more competitions.
Absolutely,
you know, we spoke to Dina Meshref the other day, and they're very busy getting ready for the Olympics.
Olympics,
and she's playing tournaments. Meanwhile, Funke Oshonake is saying she doesn't even know if she'll go to Sudan.
So that's the, that there lies the problem.
We need to correct that. You just can't stay in your sitting room and then you're doing nothing. Then the rankings come, you hope to be in the top 50.
Definitely won't happen.
You would not be in 300.
Just
kudos to Bode Abiodun and of course Aaron Okwadri. That's Aaron Okwadri at the Hungarian Open. Did well for himself, made it to the quarterfinals, went to the German Open, made it to the main draw.
Main draw, yes.
You know, that's success right there. He doesn't need to be world number one. But the story is that he's no more 48 in the world. He's not 37.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Hopefully, definitely. It's onwards and upwards and for right. Bode Abiodun and Aaron Okwadri right. in the month of February.
And we don't just want to be talking about both of them only. We want to talk about John Olapo.
That's the
he
point.
He needs to play more yeah. competitions. We even want to talk about Segun Toriola because we're in February, that crucial, decisive tournament in Sudan to see if he can pick you know,
Olympic ticket
to the Olympics. But
seventh
if we're
time.
Not talking about it mm-hmm. now, so we're like, how is he getting ready? You know?
Well, he's definitely getting ready. He knows that he needs to pick the ticket and go for his seventh Olympic, tournament. I think that's what I'm looking at. I'm looking at, you know, what he has achieved so far, you know, in table tennis. Mm. We're not looking at other sport, but we're looking at table tennis, what he has actually done for him
right.
all through the years, being to practically every Olympics, you know,
wow.
since he started playing table tennis. So that's really huge.
Massive. Yeah. So I remember when we were talking someday, you were like, a footballer yearning, praying to make it to the Olympics. A table tennis player.
It's been there how many times?
It's been there
six times. Multiple times.
Calling for his seventh appearance. You know, come on. Who says you can't shine in your own little way? And that's what we're saying. And let's also mention that big ups to the Nigeria Table Tennis Federation. When the president was here, he told us that they're going to start a junior league. Now they're getting to work. We can see that.
Starting
and that's
in March.
Protecting the future right there. So if we get more players from the junior ranks, and then monitor them to the senior ranks, that's how Aaron Okwadri started.
Surely.
You know, that's how
surely.
I remember you asked that question about secondary school when she used to go out and play, and then you come back to your school, you're like a queen. Table tennis. Table tennis.
Now that you mentioned it, I'm looking forward to that under 16
that's right.
Table tennis league when it starts in a couple of months. So, that's where we expect to get the new talents, mm-hmm. you know, that they eventually will replace the likes of Aaron Okwadri and Abiodun Bode.
That's right.
And that tournament is going to start on March 29 to April 8th. So
awesome.
About all the states across the federation have to register with ITTF. And
yep.
of course, two boys, two girls from every state will have to participate in that. It's going to be a league. Like once this league starts, I mean, it can't just be only this one. But I remember Oshidi actually talked about the fact that it depends on sponsorship.
Mm.
They have the sponsorship. It's something they want to continue. But this is going to be the very first edition on the 16th. And I hope after now, it also continues. And of course, they should be able to move it around different states of the federation. But this one is starting right here in Lagos. Well, hopefully after Lagos, it could go to other states and they can also, you know, feel the vibes of table tennis. And
right.
those who couldn't travel down, you know, to Lagos for the tournament can also have the opportunity to actually, you know, participate and also enjoy watching table tennis, not just for Lagos fans alone.
For me, I'm tired of talking about the names we discovered 4 or 5 years ago.
Yeah.
I know of Esther Ibrahim, she's a good player. Anima Shaw
Hassan
is good. Vivian is good. We want new names. You know, now in football in Nigeria, we're talking about Kelechi Nwankali. Kelechi Iheanacho has grown, now playing for the senior team of Manchester City.
Yes.
We're talking about Victor Osimhen. So you see, new names are coming up. That's what we want for boxing. That's what we want for table tennis. That's what we should be doing for weightlifting.
Absolutely.
Be part of the conversation this morning. You know what? Go to our Twitter handle. It's channels_sports and on Facebook or Channels Life in Sports. And also send us an email to sportsthismorning@channelstv.com. We told you that DR Congo, they have qualified for the final of the ongoing African Nations Championship. We said, what the finalists? You think DR Congo deserves to be in the final? We want you to talk to us. Make use of the hashtag 2016 chant. We also told you that the MPFL race, Super 4, is still on. One more game will decide who will emerge winner. So you see, football in Nigeria is competitive. Make use of the hashtag MPFL Super 4. We also spoke about Aaron Okwadri and Bode Abiodun. So let's give them some love this morning with the hashtag Quadri and Bode. They did big things by improving on the ITTF world rankings. On the show today, we want to give attention to supporter ownership. You in Aba singing Zobu Zobu Imba. What can you do to be part of the ownership of Enyimba Football Club of Aba, you in Lagos that supports MFM, Ikorodu United, stationary stores. Back in the day, fan ownership was massive with stationary stores. What is it all about? Supporter ownership in football. It took our attention today on the program. Yesterday we saw some games in the English Premier League match day 24. Odione Alo's club and Chelsea played a goalless draw. We'll talk about that one, make use of the hashtag EPL. And we told you unstoppable Steph Curry did magic against the Washington Wizards. We'll talk about Steph Curry, make use of the hashtag Curry, and of course, hashtag NBA. So much to talk about this morning on the show. Cecilia, let's go to Uyo now, where you know, a lot of people are not following what's going on with the MPFL Super Four. I think we should, because those four teams will represent Nigeria in the continent. And I'm so pleased we're seeing competitive football.
Yeah, you know, when I was watching the Nassau United and Enyimba game, I was like, okay, Enyimba defeated Warriors by a long goal. They should be able to pick this one up and see how they can actually top themselves. Because you're talking about record Nigerian champions.
Champions,
here.
Right?
And of course, we saw Mfom Udo actually, you know, came on. He started the game. I felt, okay, something good was going to come. But I was shocked when, because Enyimba just couldn't capitalize. I mean, the misfiring was so much that, of course, Nassau United had to, even from the spot kick, you know, after that penalty miss up, and the man he tripped Tayo Fabi in the box, and of course he was sent off for a second bookable offence. And the end of the day, leaving Enyimba with 10 men, the last 30 minutes.
Tayo,
so bottom line, the first goal.
I'll get you talking.
Bottom line is, your favourite, the last, right?
Definitely.
Yeah.
Okay, let's leave it like that. We'll let you see some highlights from the MPFL Super Four. We'll do that quickly, and I'll come back. We'll talk some more about the MPFL Super Four, because we're seeing some good football. Don't go anywhere. Stay with us.